Hi guys.
Hello. Hello.
We haven't filmed since we first started our 12th year of school. Yeah. So basically in today's video,
I'm making the great sacrifice. I'm making the ultimate penance.
This will benefit you when you're alone cooking, living off ramen noodles.
With this hag. I'm actually...
She's a nightmare to cook with.
No!
She's like bossy. She gets mad at me for doing things.
No!
And then when I get like drained by her, she gets mad at me for being drained because she's exhausting.
Today I'm going to be very patient, okay? I'm gonna put work into being patient, but you also have to put work into listening. I'm gonna be teaching Grace how to cook a meal that also happens to be plant-based. Why exactly are we doing this?
Because when I move...
Oh no, we don't even know if it's...
If I move to Montreal...
When you move, speak it into existence.
When I move to Montreal with my friends, one of our friends is dairy-free and gluten-free.
One of Grace's favorite meals, if it's not plant-based, is...
I love a good butter chicken.
Mm-hmm. And I thought, hey. I eat mainly a plant-based diet, so not butter chicken. We would make this butter tofu.
Now, I'm personally not a tofu enjoyer.
And we're gonna be going through the steps of home making it, okay? Everything is gonna be homemade over here. We're gonna make... We drink while Grace finishes curating a playlist, and then we will commence our cooking. Okay, so we are all ready. Try your drink. Wait, first. Good?
Yeah.
Okay, first of all, the first step in the kitchen. The hair must be back at all times.
Oh, I'm well aware.
So the first thing that we have to make is the rice for this. Also, we're gonna be improvising because Grace doesn't care for peas.
I forget.
Which is so important in cooking, to be able to improvise with the things that you have.
I forgot.
We're gonna be using...
It's like, have you never had tiki masala?
Cauliflower. I've had many kinds of masalas.
Have you had a corn?
No.
Well, then you...
I don't know. We should make a pact that when we can drink wine legally.
Hey, if you guys are being in Quebec, we can drink wine legally.
Because I was thinking about that recently, and I was like, I'm gonna come visit you and like live with you for a little bit.
What?
For like a week, maybe. You know, just to see the city.
She's still on my couch 2 months later.
I'm living under a bridge.
You just lied to me.
Basmati rice. I need to just quickly clean a pot though, because
she cooked her nose solution in it.
It's only because I'm eco-friendly, okay?
It was because she's cheap.
Yeah, get out of the way. How much am I putting
in? So first, you want to get one whole cup
of rice.
That's a whole cup.
No, Grace, see how it's not to the line?
Okay, well maybe don't yell next time.
Now it's a little over, so maybe just...
It's fine. Okay, you know what? Okay. Cooking is an art. Baking is a science. We're cooking right now, so bugger off.
Now, to that, we're gonna add how many cups of water?
3.
Yes. This is how to cook my dad's famous rice recipe. He does it great every single time.
We have all the ingredients here already.
You're gonna give people motion sickness.
No. Okay, so there's one.
I have motion sickness.
You put one in, it's 2.5.
Oh,
now we're gonna put this on the stove on medium heat until it boils.
So we're soaking up the liquid now.
It says to use like 450 grams of it. So,
how much is this?
This is 350. So cut it down the middle first, okay?
Done.
So now that our rice is boiling, just put that aside for a second.
I'm a little busy.
Well, just put it down for a second. So cover it. And then you want to turn this to low. Okay. And then we're going to set a timer for 10 minutes.
What is this?
What kind of
wondering a similar thing.
Oh no, this is a banger song.
I'm gonna measure out the
cornstarch horizontally.
This is what it looks like at the moment. Good. So now we're gonna put this into the cornstarch and toss it around.
We're gonna set this aside as we chop.
We're gonna cut the onion and the cauliflower now. Excuse me.
Okay, take this.
Thank you. Cooking tip is, I feel like plenty of people know this, but since onion will leave tastes on cutting boards, you wanna do it on a separate cutting board. Like you wanna cut onion or garlic or things like shallots and all that on a separate cutting board. Cause imagine, you're cooking something, like you cut onion on that wood cutting board back there, and then you cut strawberries on it, what do you think it's gonna taste like?
Onion, strawberries? Onions have layers? Oh, goodness, have layers. Layers.
Grabby, grabby, grabby! I wasn't grabbing anything, Grace. You don't get to do everything.
Yes, I do.
No. Why am I gonna have to do everything?
I get to do some of it as well.
No, you're supposed to be teaching, not just like...
I know, but some, like...
Okay, this is what you wanna do. First you wanna cut very small, like this much. So you wanna cut straight down. You start to kind of plug your nose manually so that you don't start crying because it decreases the amount that you're gonna cry.
I don't know how to plug my nose on command.
I'm gonna take off the skin from the onion. So what you wanna do for mincing an onion, it's quite simple. One level in here, okay? And then another level in there, like that. Are you watching, Grace?
Yeah.
Grace, don't.
No, if you bite a wooden spoon, it makes your eyes not water.
Okay, well, please don't.
What am I supposed to be doing again? I'm supposed to watch.
Give you, Grace, seriously.
I was too busy thinking about biting a wooden spoon.
You can't be getting mad at me if I'm trying to like do some of the things here. Like, next step that you wanna do, you cut slits down. Because cutting an onion is actually really important to know. So you cut just slits down, but you don't wanna cut them all the way to the stem here. Because we still wanna have a little holder. Now, what we wanna do is turn our onions, and then you just wanna cut it down right here, like this, into little pieces.
My eyes are watering. All done.
Give the look. We're just gonna put this aside for now.
Oof. Keep the demon away.
But make them into smaller pieces.
Oh, I know. Cauliflower's a regular dish at the Grace house. Because I don't like broccoli.
Look at Grace go. A cooking connoisseur.
Juliet, keep Romeo, and Romeo keeps Juliet, and it's like da 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 da, top people in the
hill. Yes. It's time to cook the tofu. So we want to get a nonstick pan, about
vegan
3
butter.
Tablespoons of vegan butter in here.
Okay.
There. Wait. We're going to heat this on medium heat.
That's good.
And then
can
we
I
have
use this to squish it around?
No. Put the tofu into that and kind of just fry that up for a wee bit until they turn golden brown. Get her done. Just, no, go all for it. You don't, because you don't want them, some of them to just have more than the others. It's gotta be consistent and proportionate. All the way, full out. Oh, don't do that.
Okay, great. Rotten.
This is Taylor's version.
Get a dish to put the dry ingredients in. Can you please measure out 2 tablespoons of nutritional yeast and 1 tablespoon of maple syrup? We're just gonna take this already minced garlic. I know that's not very homemade of us, but I don't know what you want me to say.
Where does Grace, do you want to try doing the chef shake?
Sure.
Okay. So you just go like this and you just go. Oh, jeez. I'm not even.
We need a teaspoon of some curry powder, a teaspoon of rice vinegar. Our tofu can be put onto the paper towel now. So after Grace puts that in, oh, you already put it in. Okay, don't do it like that. Just like leave it be now. Cause it'll separate once you put it in liquid. Don't do that though. overwhelmed because she's probably pretty overwhelmed in this scene, right?
Oh, are you doing some character analysis?
Now we're gonna set this aside. Your pan is hot, so now you're gonna add your onion and your cauliflower.
Can I not do the onion? I'm gonna cry.
Oh, great. Be careful though.
Now we want to let that on there for like 4 minutes.
Another half teaspoon of the mutton seeds.
We're gonna open this. Do you know how to open up?
Yeah, okay.
Oh, okay. So open. No, I wasn't sure.
That was I've made all spaghetti in my time.
We're gonna open up the coconut milk.
We're gonna cut up some cilantro.
The onions are done, all right? So now we're gonna add this baby in there.
Hey, I saw that. All of that.
Add the coconut milk. Now stir it around.
I'm just gonna turn the heat up a little bit more again because we wanna bring this to a boil. So we've added the tofu in. I don't know when the camera decided to turn off.
It was quite recent.
So now we're gonna let this sit for 5 minutes.
Oh. Grace?
No.
Now we're gonna fork the rice.
Fork?
Fluff and fork, kind of. Oh, that's good. Yeah, we fluffed it pretty well. We don't wanna over fluff.
It's
that's
so
also something that's really important.
Shut up.
Oh no, don't put it on the cookbook. You guys see how yummy it looks?
It actually smells. Does look yummy.
Now you yell, dinner's ready. That's what I always do.
Dinner's ready.
Ready?
Yes.
I quite enjoy that.
I'd like a bit more spice.
Yeah, I'm surprised
I'm surprised. I tried with the tofu, and I'm surprised I like the texture. Well, yeah. I don't like the texture, but this the taste masks the texture.
Oh,